Oh, good morning, Mr. Tyler. Going down?
Jim here. Welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to talk about how to escape a down current, or better yet, how to avoid it altogether. First on the list, and this was a point that was brought up in my last video with Chris Mears, the interview, is listen to your dive master or your dive guide or your boat briefing. Locals will know where the down currents will be and listen to their advice on that, right? So it's better to avoid a hazard than trying to climb out of one. Take those warnings very seriously. And if you have any questions about where something exists or exactly where on the navigational path, ask that question, because much better not to have a problem with something like this. Second, listen to your ears. This is something I learned early on in my training, and it was when my GUE training started, and it was talking about listening to your ears. So in other words, feeling when your ears are experiencing a pressure change. Now, normally, as a beginner, we miss all of those sensations. So if you're not able to sense that yet, maybe you need more in-water time or a little more comfort. For example, with an open water student, I often find I'm freezing in the water and they're fine. They're not relaxed enough to experience the cold yet. And ears are kind of the same thing. You'll need a little bit of in-water time to really be fine-tuning your ears to feel when they're experiencing small changes in pressure. And this is a good thing to do anytime during your dive, but it's especially useful if you're in a down current. Right. If you start to, the flags will go up. If you start to feel, if you visually haven't identified the problem yet, your ears will say, hey, something's going on, a pressure increase, check out what's going on. So listen to your ears. You feel that pressure increase, you start to check the other parameters, you know, check your depth, check your visual references, what's going on. Next, this one seems very obvious, but watch your bubbles. Bubbles do all kinds of crazy stuff in hard currents. They're gonna go sideways, they're gonna be spinning, they might do U-turns and go right back down. Well, if your bubbles are doing stuff like that, your body is soon going to follow. So watch your bubbles. It's a fantastic way to see exactly what the water's doing around you. Sometimes it's easier to see your buddy's bubbles than yours, so watch your buddy's bubbles. The next thing is looking at what I call the bottomography. And what it is often, it's a cliff of some kind. So if you're near pinnacles, well, pinnacles are, and this should be in your briefing, but pinnacles are always a natural place for down currents to happen. And what's often happening is one current is going below another or hitting a pinnacle and turning into a waterfall over that pinnacle going downward. So very often, if you're near something that looks like a cliff, it could be a natural place for a down current to form in case you haven't been briefed on that. So watch your bottomography. Pinnacles, yeah, watch out. So that being said about the idea, remember the idea of a rip current on the beach. Swimming across it is often more productive than just swimming against it. So this could be the same thing in a down current. So swimming against and upward, trying to get out of it. If you can identify what the breadth of it is, swimming across of it might be more productive than just upward in itself. So maybe a diagonal path or something like that. That being said, definitely inflating your BC is the way to go. However, be ready, because if you've fully inflated that BC to float yourself out of a down current, then once you're free of the current, you're gonna be rocketing upward. So be ready to counteract that filling of the BC with some venting and with your lungs as well. Now, a quick story of a down current. This was something I was talking with Chris Mears. So in Puerto Galera, Philippines, there are a couple spots where you can really run into some funky currents. One place is canyons, and the currents are going all over there, ups, downs, everywhere. They're multiple currents hitting each other, and whenever that happens, you're going to have some fun times. And Verde Island is a place where I really hit some interesting down currents. I was with a group, I think it was about 10 years back, and this was basically a waterfall. It was a cliff, an underwater cliff. And we were there, and it was our second dive. We got blown off this pinnacle. It was an incredibly strong current. and we kind of released, we held on and we're doing our dive as long as we could. Finally, we gave up because it was just too strenuous to hold on, and we didn't have anything more that we could hide behind. So it was toward the end of the dive, we released, and sure enough, I'm not embarrassed to say, but we were a group of, I don't know, maybe five divers, reasonably experienced, reasonably skilled divers. And I thought we were just releasing out into the blue. And little did I know, my ears started, I was like, whoa, we're getting pushed down. So I kind of filled a bit, you know, start to release. And I'm getting the signal from my ears again, I'm looking. By then I had launched an SMB and I was cranking on that SMB, but it was a more tough fight to get back from that than I had ever experienced. It was the strongest down current I had ever been in. And that was a valuable piece of experience for me that I definitely learned from. So you want to act proactively, quickly, and get out of that as soon as you're in it. Okay, hope you found that interesting or useful. If you have any stories about down currents, please post them below, including any tips you might have. Thanks again, and see you on the beach.
Man, she's got to feed the monkey. I mean, hasn't that ever occurred to you, man?
No, Mr. Lebowski, it had not occurred to me.
That had not occurred to us, dude.